Salutations, respected viewers. I'm George from Ireland. I'm outside the Tate Modern in London, this art gallery, and I've especially arranged this musical accompaniment to my commentary. So this is, was a power station built from 1957 to 1963, but it did not have very long service life, closing in 1981, burning, I'm not quite sure, was it oil, was it coal? Probably oil by that stage. So obviously the air wasn't terribly clean around here, but air quality has improved dramatically since. Clean Air Act of 1955 helped move things on, but this was obviously just within its limits. And it's amazing something so gritty and industrial was right in the city centre, but it used to be like that. Remember even in Moscow on Volota Island. Anyway, so for 19 years this city lay derelict, they decided to do something with it. And in 2000, Her Britannic Majesty opened it as an art gallery. It was called Tate after the celebrated 19th century artist Tate. There's also the Tate Britain, which is that away, which is the original Tate Gallery in Chelsea, about 5 miles along the River Thames. The Thames you'll see is just the other side of the screen. Anyway, so in the Tate Modern behind me, it is modern art. There's a clue in the word modern. It's art for the 20th century, the 21st century. And now there was a bloke called Collins, I can't remember his Christian name, Conservative MP, one of my least favourite parliamentarians. But his only good one was when he said, the only thing wrong with the Tate is the in the end, as in so much of it is craftless tat. But there's some worthy pieces of art. I've only been in once. As I recall, the admission is free. And it's huge, as you can see. There's been a bit of an extension, some building behind it. The Tate's also got branches in Liverpool and in St. Ives. St. Ives is in the southwestern toe of England. So worth visiting if you're into modern art, and the price is right. It's right beside the Millennium Bridge here. This is a Millennium project, as it opened the year 2000, the same year as that Tate Modern Gallery. And it's pedestrians only. And when they opened it, it started shaking and shaking so much that people panicked, thought the whole thing was going to collapse. Rather exasperating on its opening day to have to shut it. And engineers did all sorts of stress tests and found that it is structurally sound. Just anyway, people walking, it made it bounce a bit, but it's completely safe. So the first bridge built over the Thames in about 60 years was that one. So what a sight it is. St. Paul's Cathedral is over there. You can maybe see the dome, partly obscured by the sail of this artificial ship. So there's the River Thames, and there's a special boat going from here, that away, to the Tate Britain, where entrance is also free, and it's art from prior to 1900 up there in Chelsea. So a special boat linking the two River Tates. So that's enough from the Tate Modern. There behind you, you can see the spire above my finger, there, the tallest building in Western Europe. It's actually not that tall, 300 and something meters. Okay, I'll switch it off now.